Today we're going to be taking a look at one of my favorite death metal vocalists, George Corpsegrinder Fisher. The singer to Cannibal Corpse, and he has also come out with his own solo project. I'm going to be giving you guys some video clips of some footage that I found online, so you'll have an idea of who Corpsegrinder is if you're not a death metal fan yourself. Me personally, I'm a fan of horror movies, so when I find a music genre that's based on horror movies,
twisted, criminal, underground, stuck against another victim for complete control, raping, final.
I'm in on it, and I've fallen in love with Cannibal Corpse through the grapevine. I first started out listening to Metallica, which led me to Megadeth, which led me to Sepultura, which led me to Slayer, and then Deicide, Cannibal Corpse, and oh my god, this music is just energetic and it has such emotion. But enough of that, enough of it. Today we're going to be taking a look at some of the lesser known facts of Corpsegrinder to show that other than being the most brutal death metal vocalist that there is, he's also quite the sweetheart and the family man. George Fisher was born July 8, 1970 in Baltimore, Maryland. He is a master of those claw machines that you see at the grocery store or at the carnival. You know, the box that has the little claw that comes down, grabs a toy, and usually on its way back up, it drops it. Sorry, pal, you lose. But with George Fisher, he's a master of those. So good, in fact, that he will be on tour, see one, and grab a toy out and donate it to charity. How good is that? He enjoys playing the game and beating the game to the point that he doesn't even care about the toy, that he just likes to donate to charity. George Fisher is married to a woman and he has two daughters. I couldn't really dig up anything about how old his two daughters are, except for the fact that he donates to children with the toys that he won because his daughters are too old for toys. So, I'm hoping that they're at least teenage level. So Cannibal Corpse was formed in Buffalo, New York in 1988. That's right around the time where I was growing up. I think I was still in high school. They originally had the singer, who is currently the vocalist to 6 Feet Under, Chris Barnes. Corpsegrinder didn't replace him until 1995, after The Bleeding was released. The Bleeding was not with George Fisher, but it was with Chris Barnes, who's also an amazing vocalist. Today, Cannibal Corpse has Corpsegrinder for their singer, and they reside in Florida. According to CelebrityNetWorth.com, George Fisher, aka Corpsegrinder, has a net worth of $5 million. I say it should be a lot more than that, considering how many death metal bands his vocal style has really inspired a lot of people to thrive for. You know, between like his pig squeals, he's got the deep guttural growling that sounds like a pissed off bear on meth. It's just amazing. Prior to working with Cannibal Corpse, George Fisher worked as a driller's assistant. It's pretty cool to find out these kind of facts, that your favorite death metal singer is just a normal guy like you and me, married with two kids, held a normal working class type of a job, and didn't just pump himself out of an office and decide to start singing death metal. Nope. Working class man just like the rest of us. I'd like to talk to you now about George Fisher, aka Corpsegrinder, with his new solo project he's got right now. I've only listened to it on satellite radio, but I am going to be buying a copy of it because I'm a fan of the man, and the best way to be a fan is to actually go out and buy what they produce. The first solo release came out February 4th, and it is acid bad. Cannibal Corpse got a new guitar player, Eric Rutan, and he is featured on the song Acid Bad. Now with this new solo project that he's got out, it was a 10-song effort co-produced by Nick Belmore, who's worked with Kingdom of Sorrow, and Jamie Josta from Hatebreed from his label Perseverance Music Group. So that's it for my video today. Do you have any kind of fun facts about Corpsegrinder that I might have missed? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you're new to my channel and you haven't done so already, please help support my channel by hitting the subscribe button and hitting the like icon on the video. And let me know if you'd like to see more videos similar to this in the nearby future. Thanks for watching. You guys have a great day.